During 2015, Puerto Rico went through a severe drought that lasted almost a year. All communities around the island were affected. Millions of people, there were rationing plans across the island, many families without water for 2 or 3 days.
We have been farming for 30 years and we have had a number of periods of very little rain. We've had some difficult ones, but I believe this is one of the worst.
En los pasados años, la sequía prolongada ha afectado un sinnúmero de aspectos. En primer lugar, esto ha tenido un impacto sobre la economía local, sobre nuestros pequeños y medianos comerciantes, incluyendo las escuelas, porque cuando se implementa el racionamiento, pues entonces esto altera los horarios de operación de ellos. Número dos, nuestros agricultores se han visto afectados en términos económicos porque al depender del agua han tenido que recurrir a la compra de abonos, a la compra de químicos para garantizar sus cosechas.
One of the dangers is fire. You need to keep an eye out for smoke. Most of the time in the office, we will be checking out in case there is a fire starting somewhere.
The papaya tree should yield around 150 pounds of papaya per season. And we can see that we're missing part of the flowers here and here due to the stress created by the drought. We lost about 50% of the crop. We plant per year around 80 acres of papaya. That times 50%, it's a disaster.
Cuando la sequía empezó en Salinas, nos afectó a nosotros bastante, porque no estábamos recibiendo ni la cantidad de producto que esperábamos, ni la calidad de producto, porque era un producto flojo. Muy malo.
We have a situation where it's dry all the time, but some years it's drier, and it's been successively drying for years now. In fact, since 2011, the groundwater level has dropped by about 32 feet.
If we have a good aquifer, I call it a good aquifer, but we've been using it very hard and it's becoming too low. When I started farming, the aquifer was up to close to 15 feet from the surface. Nowadays, you go 40, 41, 42 feet down and the water level is that deep.
The Hobbs Bay Reserve has shoreline ecosystems and marine life. And one of the main species that we find a lot here is the manatee. We begin noticing that a lot of blue land crab were dead in the floor. We found trees that are very common on this side of the island dying. If you impact those ecosystems, including sea crab pests, the mangrove forest, you could also impact the economy of the area. Fisheries depends on these ecosystems.
If we don't get a solution for this, we'll probably have to go to do something else. There's no future in agriculture without a fix of the problem.
Pues el Servicio Geológico Federal lleva muchos años estudiando las condiciones del acuífero de la costa sur. Se ha notado una tendencia de deterioro del acuífero en los últimos 20 años. Este problema del acuífero aumentó durante la sequía del 2015, pues los niveles del acuífero llegaron a unos niveles bajos históricos. Estos niveles bajos en el acuífero pueden causar el problema de intrusión salina en el acuífero.
If FEMA didn't provide support for an aquifer restoration project here in Salinas, there would be very serious consequences. The water table would continue to drop because of excessive extraction. Without regulation of new wells, they would be placed very close to the sea, and the result would be that we would start to really move salt water into the aquifer area. And this is an important source of water supply for the island.
En el proceso, en los últimos años, especialmente cuando llega la sequía 2014-2016, se crea un comité para la protección de los acuíferos del sur, especialmente el de Salinas. En este comité participa la Autoridad de Acueductos y Alcantarillado, que es la que lleva agua potable a todas las familias en Puerto Rico, la Autoridad de Energía Eléctrica, que es la que maneja y administra los canales de riego en Puerto Rico, el Departamento de Agricultura, la Junta de Planificación, el Departamento de Desarrollo Económico y la Compañía de Turismo.
Como parte de los esfuerzos del departamento para lidiar con dicha situación, se estaban tratando de buscar fuentes de subvención, de asignación de fondos por parte de agencias federales para ver de qué manera podíamos lidiar con el problema del acuífero del sur.
Al evaluar la propuesta que presentó el Departamento de Recursos Naturales para el riesgo de sequía en mitigación de los acuíferos del sur, entendimos y validamos en nuestra revisión que contenía toda la información específica del problema o básicamente del daño.
Back in September 2015, we began noticing this and documenting the death of the organisms and taking pictures of the change of the area. Also, we have aerial photos where we can see some changes in vegetation.
Durante ese comité, pues estuvimos discutiendo las situaciones y tratamos de identificar distintas estrategias para ayudar al acuífero de Salinas. Una que sobresale para poder restaurar el balance en el acuífero que tiene al momento es la recarga.
The key to this project is to be able to have water available for recharge. So we have the Patillas Reservoir, which is about 20 miles away to the east and has a fairly moist watershed. And we have this reservoir, which we can visualize as a cup. And the water from the watershed goes into the reservoir. Currently, about 60% of all the water that enters this reservoir spills over and goes into the ocean. So to get the water for the recharge, what we do, we don't change the reservoir, we change the operating rule. Once the water level falls into this recharge zone, which is the very top of the reservoir, and just before it starts to spill over to the ocean, we start sending water down the canal. Now, the recharge zone allows us to reduce our losses to the ocean from 60% down to about 50%. And we can, with this mechanism, provide twice as much water as the population uses for the drinking water supply.
FEMA is a whole community concept agency. We want to have everybody involved in this. And I think that by having this committee in place, we will be able to not only accomplish the project as it is, but also motivate other communities in Puerto Rico and the U.S. Virgin Islands to pursue projects of this nature as well.
Este proyecto lo que va a provocar es que el pueblo de Salinas, sus casi 30,000 habitantes, tengan agua para poder desarrollarse, para poder tener una higiene adecuada y un proceso salubrista adecuado en esa área sur, que es un poco seca. Así que estamos esperanzados que este proyecto, cuando ya esté completado, Salinas y sus habitantes y los pueblos limítrofes puedan gozar de una buena calidad de vida con unos buenos recursos naturales. Así que esto es bien novedoso y vamos a estar bien pendientes a lo que ocurra y cómo se va a desarrollar el pueblo de Salinas después de esta noble causa.
This is a unique mitigation project in the municipality of Salinas. And that's why we feel so proud of sponsoring this mitigation project, that we know that it will serve also as an example to other communities in Puerto Rico and at the same time to other communities in the entire United States.
For more information on FEMA's grant application process, including a detailed aquifer storage and recovery checklist to assist with application development, visit us online at www.fema.gov/hazard-mitigation-assistance.